97 won the ticket, and CBS Sports Radio 1270, your homes for the NFL on Westwood One. The New England Patriots host the Buffalo Bills Monday Night Football. Pre-game at 7:30 on CBS Sports Radio 1270. Live from the Jamie Samuelson Studio, here's Stoney and Jansen.
Thankfully, their season's almost over, too. What was the most embarrassing thing about Saturday, the 47-7 debacle at Ford Field? Tommy Brady only played one half of football. Tom brought up a fabulous point about Matthew Stafford that I want to get to. But first, let's go to Dwayne in Clarkston, who's been waiting patiently. What's going on, Dwayne?
Hey, good morning, guys. I just wanted to bring up the fact that this is kind of an embarrassment for the NFL, too, and Roger Goodell, because the Lions had a depleted coaching staff. Should that game have even been played at all? I mean, what's next? The water boy is going to be the next coach of the team just to keep the game going? I don't know how you guys feel about anything like that.
Well, Dwayne, the issue that I have, being a former player, these guys are supposed to be professionals. And I'm going to talk about this at the top of the next hour a little bit more. Especially 15 games into a season where they've been virtual, they've been a lot of Zoom, an offseason where they've had to be self-motivating, they've had to watch film, they've had to do things on their own. They should be at a point where they should professionally prepare themselves enough not to be embarrassed whether your coach is available or not. Is there a difference between good coaches and bad coaches? Yes, that's why good coaches get fired all the time. And they were at a disadvantage. But I would rather be down a coach. And I don't know if you heard my comparison to Denver earlier. Denver was without a quarterback. I'll ask you that, Dwayne. Would you rather be without any of your starting quarterbacks or any of your quarterbacks on your roster or down a coach?
Right. I'll wait to get it. You're absolutely right. If you're a good team and you have good backup,
played without Lamar Jackson. The Browns just played without a ton of receivers. John Manch mentioned that the Broncos played without any quarterbacks. Like, the NFL's been consistent. They want to get these games in. And listen, the Lions are going to win, no. But you should never, I don't care if I'm coaching, you should get blown out 47-7. So, I mean, listen, I'm not going to blame the NFL. I think that's weak. I know you're not. I'm just saying, I totally get what the NFL is doing. This is on the Lions. It's always been on the Lions.
This game turned out the way it did, though, because Matthew Stafford got hurt. You're looking at a 41-45-21-24 type game for Stafford plays, and that's why I made the point before the break before about this being 2008 all over again plus Matthew Stafford. You know, he's the reason why they're not 2-14 this year.
I don't disagree. I think you're right about that. I do. Now, with that being said, and I want to hear what John says too. With that being said, Matthew Stafford has had chances when he had actual good surrounding pieces. He has. Like, in 2014, they had a very good defense. Where the hell was Stafford? Would it matter? 2013. So, while you're dead on, Tom, and maybe that's probably why you bring him back next year, it's not like Stafford's been great when the other team has been moving the team.
To me, though, the Stafford puzzle is solved.
To say that just yet. But he does raise a point. I mean, Matt Stafford was the best thing about this team other than Kenny Golladay, and Galladay's been hurt all season, it seems like. He's missed 8 games in a row. So I hear what Tom's saying. With that being said, though, my goodness, forget about Stafford for a second. You know, let's talk about Quinn and Patricia. Like, Matt Patricia comes in here. We know this. The rocket scientist, the defensive genius. John, 3 last place finishes in a row. And this defense is not just horrendous. It is worse than horrendous. They have a chance to be the worst defense in the history of the game.
Well, the 3rd year in a row, we have a pick that's in the top 8.
Yeah.
All right. And well, thanks to Matt Patricia, we've been able to acquire some good young talent. And you can argue whatever you want about the draft position or the draft picks that we've had. But you can't continue to lose games. And yes, I agree that the difference between this year's team and the 2018 is Matt Stafford. But, and I've said this before, you're not going to win. Yeah, but you're not going to win because of Matt Stafford. You can win with him, but not because of him. So, yes, to answer and to respond to Tom, he does need parts around him. He does need a really good defense. He needs a running game. He needs things. He needs targets to throw the ball to. But that's the issue that I've always had. When you look at, and I know people hate this when I compare them to a Tom Brady or an Aaron Rodgers. They haven't always had all of the pieces around it. When I watch Kansas City, when I watch Green Bay, yesterday, Kansas City's a great point in fact. They couldn't get anything going right until the final 2 minutes of the first half. Then they finally score a touchdown. They tie things up going into halftime. They find a way to get 17 points when they don't have anything going for them. That's the difference. When the Lions don't have anything going for them, they can't manufacture drives. They can't manufacture points. Matt Stafford can't manufacture wins.
I agree with you. And, Tom's point's a very good one, a salient one. But that being said, though, we're just talking about the last 3 years because Patricia was that bad. Give me Matt Stafford under Jim Caldwell. Give me Matt Stafford under Jim Schwartz. Matt Stafford at times, I think you're dead on, John, has not been good enough.
The 2014 team, though, is the team that shows why Stafford isn't the answer. Because you had a top 5 defense, yet he couldn't get it done, and they got some unfortunate luck down in Dallas with that play, but he had the ball. I still think people are going to get sick of me saying this. He had the ball still, and they could have drove the field and won that game in Dallas, and he failed. He went 4-0. It was a lifeless performance out of him. That's why he has to have everything perfect for him, too.
Well, and he
has to get rid of the field. He's just an 8-8 quarterback. So he makes bad teams mediocre, and he makes maybe great teams mediocre, too.
Right.
You see what I'm saying?
Yes, it's the unanswerable question, but I want to hit this. Okay, John Jansen is going to take us in the trenches next. And then I want to go back to this because I think it's so interesting. The Stafford effect on all of this. Speaking of interesting, the great Tony Ortiz with the sports update. A 97 minute time.
WXYT FM and WXYT HD1 Detroit. A radio.com sports station. Sports headlines. All day, every day. From the sold by YC Sports Desk. This is 97.1.
Something brought to you by Buff Whalen Chevrolet. The Lions improved their draft prospects to a number 7 pick in the draft order after yesterday's results, and they could finish as high as 3, depending upon what happens in the final week. Jacksonville clinched the top pick after the Jets upset Cleveland yesterday. The Chiefs, meanwhile, clinched the top seed in the AFC. Seattle, Pittsburgh, both clinching their division. And last night was Green Bay 40-14 over Tennessee. Monday Night Football, New England hosting Buffalo. And these two NFL teams reportedly have reached out to Urban Meyer about coaching in the NFL next year. No word of whether the Detroit Lions are one of those teams or not. NFL reportedly set to expand their regular season to 17 games next year. College basketball tonight. Michigan State in the world of hurt. They dropped 2 in a row during Minnesota. Baseball trade. Tampa Bay sending pitcher Blake Snell to the Padres for a catcher and 3 prospects. San Luis Hall of Fame pitcher Phil Niekro dies at the age of 81. This is play the Hawks. 7-1 ticket. Pistons at 0-2. They signed Frank Jackson to a two-way contract. Blake Griffin out with injury or illness tonight. Derrick Rose is out due to load management after two games. At the ticket update desk, I'm Jeff Lesson. For more, 97.1 the ticket or radio.com.
The Trenches with John Jensen, powered by BetQL. Bet smarter and beat the books. Download the BetQL app today or visit BetQL.com.
Oh, that's right, in the trenches. Take it away, John Jensen.
Well, I'm going to switch up the order a little bit of what I was talking about, because earlier we were talking about, you know, the fact that the Detroit Lions were down five coaches. And I just want to reemphasize that it's not like being down five coaches in college or in high school. If it was in high school, you wouldn't even have a game because you would have no coaching staff left. These are professional athletes. They are paid to do a job. They don't have to go to class. They don't have any other responsibilities. Yes, they have families. Yes, you have life. I understand all of that. But we all have those things, yet we still try and figure out a way to prepare for our jobs and perform our jobs when required. On Saturday, they were required to perform a job. This is a year where, in the offseason, you learn, as we all did, how to utilize Zoom, how to utilize technology to prepare for your job, watching film. This has been something that the NFL, not knowing, has been preparing for some time. When I was at the end of my career, this is 12 years ago, now 10 years ago, it was when you could start taking home film on devices to be able to watch film at home and be able to study while you were at home, while you were away from the facility. It's even more so now, the ability to study and prepare for your job while you are away from the office. This is not just unique to the NFL. This is something that is almost universal across the country. Now, there are certain jobs, obviously, you have to be in person to be able to do, but you can prepare for a lot of what you have to do at home. It's called studying. Rigor, did you study when you were in college?
I'd rather not answer that question.
As I was asking that,
my grades will reflect that.
But if you have, all right, you would have performed better.
Yes, I would have. If I was prepared, yes, I think I would have got higher than a C average.
So the excuse of, hey, they were down five coaches, I understand that you don't have that leadership. There are different voices. And yes, that does impact the performance on game day. But this is not unique. Yesterday's performance for this 2020 football team was not unique to this team. It wasn't the first time that they've given up 40-plus points in a game. It was the fifth time this season that they've given up 40-plus points to an opponent. They have given up a league-worst 32.1. I want to make sure I put that .1 in there because it's very important when we start talking about what could happen this coming week. And you mentioned it earlier, Reeves. It's 35 points, and they will have the worst score defense the Lions have ever had in the history of the Lions organization.
If they give up 60 or more, it is the worst scoring defense in the history of the NFL. Wrap your mind around that.
Well, I will. I don't think we're going to give up 60 points to Kirk Cousins. But who knows?
Dalvin Cook's pretty good.
Right. Yeah, he is, but it takes time to learn. So that's the issue I have, is that these are professionals. And when you go out on the field, at some point, pride and the fact that you are preparing not just for this year, but you don't know who the coach is going to be next year. You don't know who your GM is going to be. You are auditioning for 31 other teams, along with the Detroit Lions, the 32 entire teams. You are auditioning for probably close to 40 individuals, because you don't know who those new GMs are going to be across the NFL. They're looking for a GM down in Jacksonville. They're looking for GMs, you know, at different places around the NFL. And so you don't know who you're auditioning for. All you know is that you want to continue to be a professional football player, and that you are preparing to audition for your team, for other teams around the NFL, and I found it extremely lacking. The motivation was lacking. When you're down, you have to find a way to generate some excitement without getting a taunting penalty or shushing a non-existent crowd. And now I'm going to go to some of that. Some of that preparation that I saw lacking was, yes, there is a different lineup up front for the offensive line. Joe Dahl was at center. You didn't have Frank Ragnow, who I think is one of the best centers in the NFL. But Joe Dahl knows he is going to be the starting center. When you prepare and you're watching film, blitz pickup is one of the most important aspects of being a center. You have to communicate with the rest of your offensive line. You have to communicate with your quarterback. You get with every single quarterback because you know Matt Stafford is coming into this game injured already with his ribs. You didn't know he was going to leave because of an ankle injury, but he's injured because of a ribs. If he takes a hit, now all of a sudden you may have Chase Daniel in the game. You have to communicate with him. You have to work with him. The center quarterback exchange that happened on, the, I think, the second drive that Chase Daniel was in there, you can't have those and expect to be in a game where you're playing a team like the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, who is explosive on offense. They're finding their way, and they're a very good defense. They've been a good defense all year long. So when you're looking at blitz pickup, it's not as simple as I'm going to make it sound, but I'm going to make it sound extremely simple. Typically, in any given defense, you've got four defensive linemen, or those that you classify as defensive linemen, and three linebackers. So you've got seven up front. Now, you may have a different combination. You may have three up front and four linebackers, but you have to pick out the middle of the three linebackers that you believe is the Mike linebacker. It becomes tricky when you start having, you know, nickel defense, dime defense, because you have different players' jerseys in there, and maybe they're over a slot receiver, but you have to identify who those are and then pick out the middle of the three. That's where you set your protection. Your quarterback may redirect you, but you set your protection there. That way, everybody up front knows exactly who they are blocking, and the quarterback knows, more importantly, who you are blocking and who he is throwing hot off of. If that doesn't happen, if there's a miscommunication, that's where you run into problems. And the Detroit Lions, the offensive line, ran into those problems, mainly because I don't feel like they were prepared up front for blitz pickup. The final thing I'm going to talk about is the quarterback. And I know Tom mentioned this earlier. You have referenced this. I think the Detroit Lions need to prepare not for next year, because if Matt Stafford is back for another year, whether it's contract, whether it's the new GM likes him or doesn't like him, doesn't matter. If he is back next year, you have to prepare for 3 years down the road. Now, maybe in 3 years, you're still playing against Aaron Rodgers, but you could be playing against Jordan Love. That's who you have to prepare to be better than the Green Bay Packers. We don't know who the quarterback is going to be for the Minnesota Vikings. I doubt it's still Kirk Cousins. It's probably not anybody on their roster. And we don't know who it is for.
It's not Trubisky, for sure. We know this, yes.
But if it is Mitch Trubisky, you have to prepare to beat the Chicago Bears in 3 years. So you have to, and I think it's imperative, if you're going to have a top seven pick, which is right now where the Lions pick is number seven overall. It could be as high as three, but I think it's going to be somewhere five, six, seven. You have to be ready to draft your quarterback or give up picks to move up to get the quarterback that you need in 3 years to compete with the Green Bay Packers, the Chicago Bears, and the Minnesota Vikings. You have to be able to win your division and win games in your division. If you can't, the rest of the NFC does not matter. So for the Lions right now, you have to look and say, okay, Matt Stafford, if he is going to be back next year, that's fine. I have no problem with that. But he is not your quarterback for 3 years down the road. He will be gone. You have to draft your next guy. And just take a look at what Green Bay has done. And I hate to use somebody in our division as an example, but they've got Brett Favre. They draft Aaron Rodgers. They groom him. They let him grow. They let him develop. Now, all of a sudden, he's having an MVP-type season. I think he should win the MVP, but they drafted Jordan Love. They're going to allow him to develop. That's what the Lions need to do. The most important position in professional sports, I believe, is your quarterback. Unless you have a quarterback that can go out there and win games, you're always going to be 8-8, 9-7, 5-11, whatever it is, but it's not going to be good enough to win championships. You have to sacrifice maybe one or two drafts to get that quarterback so that you can build around him and be the team that you want to be in 3 years.
Speaking of quarterbacks, find out what one potential GM had to say about our quarterback. We'll play that for you next. We'll talk Stafford, that's in the trenches with John Jansen, 97.1 The Ticket.
97.1 The Ticket. Traffic.
From the WWJ AM 950 Traffic Center, we are still accident-free out on the roads this morning. Keeping an eye on construction, a quick reminder that Mount Elliott and East Grand Boulevard are still closed over I-94. Those closures now extended through March 5th. I'm Julia Deal in the WWJ 24-Hour Traffic Center.
MGM, the first official sports betting partner of the Detroit Lions, is coming soon to Michigan, but you can sign up right now with a special early registration offer. Open a BetMGM account today, and you'll receive $100 in free sports bets and $100 in free casino bets. It's the best way to be ready for action the moment BetMGM begins accepting wagers, and there's no deposit required. Enjoy the same excitement you've come to expect at MGM Grand Detroit on an easy-to-use, state-of-the-art app. And find out why BetMGM is the king of sportsbooks with the best daily promotions. Plus, play your favorite casino games anytime from anywhere in Michigan. It's almost showtime at BetMGM. Get on it early by signing up today and get $100 in free sports bets and $100 in free casino bets that you can use as soon as the fun starts at BetMGM. Must be 21 years or older. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-270-7117 for confidential help. Excludes Michigan disassociated persons.
Text the ticket using the same number you used to call the ticket. Ticket text 248-539-9797. In need of hip, knee, or joint replacement? For better, faster recovery experience, discover the difference of robotic-assisted joint replacement at Straith Orthopedics at Straith Hospital, number one in Southfield, Michigan. Offering robotic technology to provide patients with precise joint replacements and rapid recovery. Straith Orthopedic Specialists are available for same-day appointments and walk-ins welcome. Call 855-STRAITH to schedule an appointment now. That's 855-STRAITH or visit straith.org. Go straight to Straith Orthopedics at Straith Hospital.
This is the last week for Gordon Chevrolet's fantastic December deals. GM employee price, the real GM employee price to everyone. Plus, you'll get all the Gordon and GM incentives. Inventory is slim, so don't wait. No money down leases starting under $200 and lease go-ahead programs. Gordon Chevrolet will be open New Year's Eve till 6 and Saturday. Everything ends Monday, January 4th. Don't miss out. The Gordon Chevrolet on Corn Road just west of Merrimack and Garden City. Gordon Chevrolet.
97.1 The Ticket at Ellison Brewery have teamed up
restrictions apply. New performance starter internet customers only. Equipment taxes, regulatory recovery, and other fees next term subject to change. After term, regular rates apply. Based on route metrics by IHS Markit's Route Score Reports 2H2024 mobile networks. Actual savings vary and are not guaranteed.
Get together and spend like Dodge and Aurora for the big finish 2020. You can lease a Dodge Challenger Scat Pack for just $339 per month. That's right, lease a Dodge Challenger Scat Pack for only $339 per month. Come by and see why Galliana spend like Dodge has Metro Detroit's largest selection of Dodge Challenger and Charger Scat Packs, Hellcats, and Hellcat Red Eyes in stock and ready to go. Or lease a well-equipped 2021 Ram 1500 Bighorn 4x4 for just $137 per month. Come see why Galliana spend like Dodge and Ram has Metro Detroit's best selection of Ram trucks. That's right, lease a brand new Ram 1500 Crew Cab 4x4 for only $137 per month. Check out these incredible prices. Brand new Grand Caravans under 20 grand. And new Journeys just $17,439. Worried about credit? Forget it. We approve almost everyone. Galliana's Van Dyke Dodge. Located on Van Dyke Avenue, just north of 696 and more. Or VanDykeDodge.com. Title destination adopt fees 24 months for Ram, 39 month lease for Scat Pack and Poly leases with owner loyalty, $29.95 to Rutani. All rebates to be due to credit approval required.
Prescription products require an online physician consultation and are only available if the physician determines a prescription is appropriate. 90-day money-back guarantee available for finasteride only. Subscription required. See website for full details and important safety information.
Maybe you've noticed thinning hair. Maybe you're wondering if you'll inherit your dad's bald spot. It doesn't have to be destiny. With Hims, you can get doctor-trusted treatment to tackle your hair loss sent right to your door. Just answer some questions online and get connected with a licensed medical provider to figure out what's right for you. And when you go to forhims.com/growth, you can get that first expert consultation for free. Hims has everything from Luxe thickening shampoo to FDA-approved, clinically proven prescription pills to help stop loss and even regrow hair. If prescribed, it's shipped right to you. No waiting weeks for an appointment, no pharmacies, no trying to figure out what actually works alone. Get years of confidence for less than $1 per day. Get your free visit at forhims.com/growth. If you're not happy with the results in 90 days, Hims can give you a full refund. Go to forhims.com/growth for your free visit. forhims.com/growth.
This hour of Instant Feedback brought to you by Mike Capura of National Benefit Plans. For affordable life insurance, call 877-734-2200.
The only way you can take 97.1 The Ticket with you is the Radio.com app. Download it today and listen to us anytime, anywhere. Live from the Jamie Samuelson studio, here's Stoney and Jansen.
Stoney will be back on Monday. He'll be back next year. That's right, when 2020 is finally over. Before we move on, guys, a lot of people to get to on the phone lines talking about Stafford. How should the next GM proceed? Maybe you keep Stafford for another year. Do your best to plug and play that defense and hope that you make the postseason and give this suffering fan base 1 year of excitement before you start somewhat of a rebuild, or maybe even a rebuild on the fly, or do you just blow it all the F up? So we can answer the question. A lot of ticket texts to get to as well. But I want to ask you guys a question. A quick trivia question that kind of proves my point. What do Tahir Whitehead, Darius Slay, and Quandre Diggs all have in common? Go ahead.
They're all probably all going to the playoffs this year. No, Darius Slay is not because he's with the Eagles.
Yes. They all had a pick yesterday. Quandre Diggs, his fifth pick yesterday. Slay and Whitehead had interceptions as well. If you have any football brain at all, which Quinn and Patricia did not, those three guys, at least two of those three guys, are still on the Detroit Lions defense, making it not as inept as it is, meaning as long as you make some better decisions, you could, I think, flirt with the postseason with a decent offense like the Lions have.
What are you trying to do, though? I don't understand. Why would you want to do that for 1 year versus right now you have the opportunity to separate yourself from Kenny Golladay, who does not deserve superstar wide receiver money? Okay, you can franchise him. I get what you're saying. I don't understand. Whatever. Right now you can get a clean break. If you're ever going to trade Stafford, this is the offseason to do it.
Sure.
There's several teams in this league that are not going to pick high enough to get, you know. To me, first off, the only can't miss is Lawrence. Justin Fields, man, I'm telling you what right now, I think he's going to bomb if in the NFL, if you ask me. I'm not sold on Kyler Murray yet as an NFL starting quarterback. I don't see Fields even touching what Murray is in the NFL. So, to me, it's Lawrence, and then I have my feelings about Trask, who I think, because I love accuracy over mobility, that I still think he's got a chance. And who knows? One of these other quarterbacks are going to make it. But there's teams in this league right now that would think, okay, because they believe the national narrative with all the analysts nationally that they all love Stafford. You can't find one that will truly look at everything as it is. No national analyst ever brings up his pick sixes.
Rich Gannon, and I think he's the only one to ever bash Stafford. Everybody else loves him.
I mean, but there's teams that believe it too. There are teams in this league, I truly believe. John Elway is desperate to save his job.
San Francisco.
Yeah.
What about New England?
Well, so you look at New England, you look at San Francisco, you look at teams that, and I don't necessarily know that New England is built to win next year, but they're built more than some other ones. San Francisco, once they get their defense back and healthy, they could be, Brandon Ayuk as one of their wide receivers, young rookie this year, could be a team that goes from a non-playoff team. They were, a Super Bowl contender a year ago.
But Matthew Stafford's a better quarterback than Jimmy Garoppolo.
Right, so if you're looking for places to trade Matt Stafford that are in a win-now mode, you've got to look at, I would think San Francisco would be at the top of the list.
I can name six or seven. I mean, Chicago is looking for a quarterback. They can get rid of Foles if they so chose. You mentioned San Francisco. One of their coaches, unnamed, has already said Stafford can win us a championship. That's two. What happens with the Saints? That's three. The Colts could be four. Dallas could be five. I mean, Denver is six. So I agree with you guys. I think he's definitely tradable, and you can maybe get the Redskins or seven. They're probably not going to war with Alex Smith. So that's seven people, and teams rather. I agree with you guys.
Well, and Jeff, here's the deal. The Niners pick 14th right now. The Patriots, 15. Vegas, I think, could be included in this. 16.
Not bad.
You brought up Washington, 19. What if Phillip Rivers retires? The Colts, they're back in 18th right now.
I brought up a league.
So you've got, those teams would be willing to give up that first round pick.
I agree. And I'm with you guys. I'm just trying to supply the other belief. That's all. Let's go to Larry in Monroe. You're on the ticket. Hey, what's up, Larry?
Stafford and Jansen for a minute.
All right.
So
both winners in my
book. Right. So Stafford has been a beautiful fit this year. And they started off with some big leads and unable to finish. But until he plays linebacker, safety, corner, or defensive tackle, the long leads can't go on him.
Unless you give him the ball back. And you you turn the ball over, you take sacks, you give Aaron Rodgers the ball back when you've got double-digit lead just before halftime. You just can't continue to give these other teams opportunity.
Well, I agree, but every now and then you got to count on your defense giving you a stop. And you keep on bringing up this J.J. Watt interception. You think it has a bad play on Stafford, but don't recognize that even with what and tackles who caught the ball at waist high. How many quarterbacks throw a pass waist high? Most of the time, they're jumping up to catch it fast. You don't acknowledge that maybe he made a good play, and Stafford, well, it wasn't a bad play, but it might not have been the best play.
Well, to your point, Larry, yes, it was a very good play by J.J.